Hello and welcome back to Natural Gardening with Green Fingertips. My name is Josie and I am your natural gardening coach. If you want to see videos on how to grow and support your garden naturally, reduce the reliance on chemicals, promote the health, overall health of your garden, and encourage more wildlife to live in your garden, then keep on watching. So today we are talking about how to attract wildlife into your garden and support the wildlife living within your garden. So why is it important to have wildlife living in your garden? Now, I don't know about you, but I love to look out of my kitchen window with a cup of tea and watch the birds in the trees, the squirrels playing around, and I just love seeing all the activity in the garden. Now that on its own is worth it, but they can play a really big role in the support and the care of your garden. In the Gardeners membership this month, we are talking about how to attract in and how to support wildlife in your garden, how they can support your garden and you as a gardener, and all the benefits that they can offer as well. So we're covering all of that in the Gardeners membership this month. I will put a link in the description below so you can check that out. So if you go to the link, it will take you through to the page and then you can see all the details of what the Gardeners membership offers. But yeah, I look forward to seeing you over there. So how can we support and attract more wildlife into our garden? Now, there's many ways you can do this, and they don't have to cross the earth. They can be totally free, and they can all be incorporated into your garden. These are just some of the ways that are so simple, so easy, and very effective ways, shall we say, very effective, that you're going to get the quickest response from them. So provide housing. Different wildlife obviously requires different types of housing. Provide nesting material. And feed and forage. If you're homing them, you want to feed them as well. Genius. If you're getting value from this video, give us a thumbs up. Let's talk about the different housing options, if you like. So housing can be as simple as going to your garden centre or going on Amazon, for instance, and you can buy bird boxes, species-specific bird boxes. You can buy mouse houses if you want to try and attract, like, field mice, dormice, that sort of thing, into your garden, vole houses, all sorts of different things you can buy. There are thousands of options out there, believe me. You can really go to town on it if you want to spend a fortune. You've got squirrel boxes as well, all sorts of things. You can even get the ones with a camera so you can see them inside. You can like Wi-Fi it to your house so you can see them all. So if you're really interested, there's all sorts of them. But you don't have to spend a fortune. They will appreciate a bundle of sticks and logs in the corner of your garden in a nice shady area built up. That will create homes for all sorts of different insects and mammals and all sorts. And a little pile of stones will be a home to all sorts of different insects. And it all supports them. They'll love that. They'll love it. If you've gone out and bought a bee hotel or an insect hotel, so easy to make yourself. So they work out really well for if you want to make homes for bees, for different insects. Butterflies will lay will hide their chrysalises in there, or chrysalises. The stones and the logs and the twigs and everything work really well as well. So you can even bundle up, tie together a bundle of bamboo canes, just short bamboo canes, so you can get a foot or 2 foot bamboo cane and then bundle up, cut them in half and then bundle them again, so you've got a little stack of bamboo canes. So cheap, so easy to do, and then just leave them in the corner of your garden somewhere, and just they'll become a little home for all sorts of little insects and things. They'll love it. Now, ground cover as well. Ground cover provides an incredibly important function for the garden, for support for cover. Ground dwelling creatures, they need the ground cover. They nest lower to the ground. They need the ground cover more than they need the higher up boxes. And then finally, trees. Trees provide obviously a lot of spaces, a lot of areas for birds to nest, squirrels to nest, anything tree dwelling. High up support, it protects them. You can put a bird box in a tree and they will love that as well. So if you want to go out and buy a bird box, or you can download patterns to make your own bird box. So easy to make. I've even made one before, and I'm no good with things like that at all. So yeah, you can make bird boxes so easily and then put them up in your tree. If you've got a tree in your garden, you're onto a winner. Now let's talk nesting material. So nesting material could be anything from a bag of straw that you buy from your local pet shop. It could be, you can get the man-made like nesting fluff that you can get that they can just pick out and draw out and make nests out of. Growing a variety of different plants in your garden will also provide a range of different nesting materials for the birds, for the mice, and for all sorts of mammals and things. So to line their nests and line their beds with. So by growing a variety of different plants, you're providing a variety of different housing for them, nesting materials, and we go on to next, food as well. So different plants produce different seeds, different berries, different types of food for the different animals to eat. So by growing a variety of different plants, you're going to attract into your garden a variety of different animals, which is what we want. Because the variety of different creatures feed in different ways, they'll support your garden in different ways, and they'll just benefit everything, benefit you as a gardener from watching them thrive in the garden, will benefit your garden. So yeah, we really want to attract in a variety rather than just one sort. A variety will be better for the garden overall. When you're tidying your garden for the autumn and winter, when you're giving everything a good cut back and tidy, leave an area. If you've got a wild area that you're using to support the wildlife, perfect. Don't cut the seed heads down, leave them to it. Leave them to self-seed, because free seed, hello, free plants, perfect. But yeah, give the seeds to the wildlife. They'll come and find it. They'll know it's there. They'll smell it for miles. They'll know. So by doing that, you're going to be providing them with a variety of different foods. Different shrubs, roses even, for instance, provide hips, berries, different seed pods. All these different variants, if you like, of a seed will provide different creatures with different types of food. So it doesn't have to cost a fortune to feed your wildlife. You can go out, and which we'll go on to next, you can go out and buy a variety of different, like specially mixed seeds and suet treats and pellets and nuts and all sorts of things that these marketing people are saying, oh, this is what you need, this is what they love, la la la, and cost you a small fortune. We could just plant a really varied garden and provide them with everything naturally. They'll find it. They'll know what they need and they will find it from your garden. A really good tip as well for the winter, if you can, provide a higher calorie. If you buy your food, if you provide seed, if you've got feeders, is to provide a higher calorie mix. So if you've got peanuts out, that's a really good high fat, high calorie content, which is what the wildlife needs in the winter, because they get really cold and they burn calories so much faster than they would do in the spring and summer, that they need these higher calories. So peanuts, suet treats, so suet pellets, the blocks you can get, the little fat balls, anything like that, that's really good high calorie foods. So no good for the spring summer, because they don't need so much calories and it won't do them any good. They'll binge on it as well, so they will eat it still, they will love it, it's just like fast food for them at that point. But in the winter time they could really use it, so it's really good to focus it in the winter, in autumn winter time, and then don't buy it so much spring summer. We'll take it out in the spring, summer. Try and grow as much as you can, a varied commodity, if you like, varied plants in your garden. But by providing the peanuts and the suet, you're really going to help them out a bit more. Like, they're really going to attract them into your garden, so then they can find the rest of it. And then lastly, water. Now, water is really undervalued when it comes to people thinking about feeding their wildlife in their garden. In the wintertime, as we can probably understand, water freezes. Now water, the natural water sources that the wildlife in your garden or living around you would go to might not be there in the winter, because it's either frozen or contaminated with like the mud and the dying back plants and things. But yeah, they wouldn't be able to find it normally. So they will be going on the hunt for it. Really good way of attracting them into your garden is provide them with water. If you have a bird bath, if you have a shallow bowl of fresh water out every day for them. If you've got a shallow bowl or bird bath, if you put a few stones in the bottom for like insects and any amphibians or anything that go in and then they can't get themselves back out again. Even a bird that might fall in and struggle. If it's too deep, it's going to be a bit of a risk for them. So if by having a shallower bowl, or one with wide sides, like sloped sides, and a few stones in the bottom, it just gives them a bit of support if they fall in. They can get back out again easily. So providing them water is really important, and safe water is even more important as well. I really hope these have given you some good ideas as to how you can support and attract more wildlife into your garden. And if you want to know, obviously, if you want to know more about how they can support your garden and support you as a gardener, and we got so many ways. There's so many ways they can support us. It's going to be amazing. Join me in the Gardeners membership and we'll go into great detail on that through November. But the training will be, training is always saved in the Gardeners membership private Facebook group. It'll be saved for 30 days and then it's deleted from the group. So if you want to join, I will leave the link in the description. I always leave the link in the description anyway, but check it out down there. And then you can go, it'll take you through to the page, and you can read all about it and then sign up there, which is perfect. So if you're getting value from this video, give us a thumbs up if you like what you're seeing. And if you want to subscribe to see more videos like this from myself, click the subscribe button that's hovering above me here. And if you want to see the next video in the run that I've set up for you, click the little box that's floating above me here. So I will see you in the next video, and I really hope you enjoyed it and you got value from this. And I look forward to seeing you in the membership very soon. See you later.